committee. Festival garden.
What are the practices that I will teach you?
Accrediting bodies, But again, professional standard. So whoever wants to open an ECD, they are supposed to consult the professional standard. They are supposed to follow the professional standard. They are supposed to follow the laws of the country. But again, they should also follow the rules of the accrediting body. The in-house style, but the general view is supposed to follow one or the same standard. However, I repeat, there are differences, and because of the individual as well as cultural variances that exist. If someone wants to open an ECD and they want you to follow a curriculum model which is Montessori, whatever they are going to be doing within that school is not going to be the same kind of actions or activities that are going to happen in another school that is following one curriculum model. The same with another high school curriculum model. These are going to be the difference. But as we are looking at these differences in the curriculum model and activities that are happening within the school, these guys are going to be following the same accreditation standards. They will follow the same law. They will also follow the same professional standard. Does that make sense?
Yes.
So, these variations can happen within a country, but they can also happen between countries. Because countries have got different cultures, but again, they have got different laws, they have got different professional standards that they follow. But within a nation, there has to be standardization. But at the same time, there are also other laws that are international. When we talk about the right to education, you will find the right to education in Malawi, Mozambique, USA, and so on and so forth. So some of the laws are international, some of them are national. So, my point is, there are standards that are uniform, there are standards that are varying according to the place in which the ECD is existing. Another, there is also test-based high-stakes accountability and testing. It is even left
valid and reliable. What does that mean? Educational measurement is not an exact science. And with young children, it is even less reliable and valid. What does that mean? When you read that sentence, what do you understand? Okay. Testing and measurement. When you're in seminar 5, you sit behind a desk and you learn. By the end of the term, you give an exam where you write your paper and then you submit the teacher mark. But we're talking about early childhood education. Okay, so even in 74, where a child is going to write exams and submit, people argue to say that this is not a standard, the best way to know whether the child has learned or not. Because there are other children that are going to be in a position to absorb everything that the teacher is saying. Come exam, they are not in a position to write. Maybe because they are afraid or scared of the word examination, and everything else that is in their mind goes away. They put nothing on paper. But if you ask them questions orally, they are going to respond. Sometimes, it is also argued to say, when you tag examinations to learning, students, what they will do is they will concentrate on the areas where they know this is where the examination questions come from. So the whole idea of understanding the whole process of a course or a subject is put aside. What they are targeting is simply to make sure they pass the exam. That's one argument. The other argument is, here is a four-year-old child who is being given exams. That's okay, they can write. But now, let's talk about the toddler who is about 2 to 3 years. What kind of an examination are you going to do? Is it really important? Is it really going to reflect the level of development through which the child is going? 4, 3 to 5, give them an exam. Is it really important? Is it really going to reflect what the child is attaining? So when we are talking about educational measurement is not an exact science with young children. We are talking about that. There are also other degrees whereby it is allowed to say you are going to go through a first year, second year, third year, fourth year without exam. What you simply do is be given assignment. So I'll give you an assignment, 15 pages. Make sure you're writing within this period. Maybe within one course, I give you about 4 assignments. You finish that, you mark, and then you're being graded. Years are going on until fourth year where you're going to get your degree. It is happening. There is a course in Zuzu which offers a master's like that. People don't seek for exams. They simply go through the learning process. So, given that kind of a scenario, and another scenario where it is exam oriented, which one do you think students will be in a position to learn more? Putting aside your laziness. Putting aside laziness, all things concerned, let's look at two people that are really wanting to be educated. One is going through exams, the other one is just going through assignments. Which one do you think is going to be more lazy than the other one?
The one
that
was assigned.
Exam? Why are you saying the exam one is going to be more learned than the other one? All of them, they are going
lectures, right?
Yeah.
Lecturing is taking place.
He's meant by say the one with the title is the one who is going to share the progress by on learning. Just an example like let's take it here in this class which we are having. The rector just said like we should during the time of exams, when the exams are approaching, find that we are really asking for the study areas. Why are we asking for the study areas? We want to concentrate much on those particular areas, but once we find the other aspects, we don't even care. But let's come to this guy who is doing an assignment. For the assignment, you explore more, because you find that an assignment is giving you something like 5 pages, 6 pages, or even 10 pages. So you dig more and you try to get more information about the given topic. But on the exam, you can just even write even 1 page, not even 1,000 words. So you just apply some little knowledge. But when on the assignment, you explore more and you get to learn more when you are doing some research and the like.
Okay.
Alright. Well, then we say the exam. Yeah, okay. Well, as you, I think it's point, okay? When you ask me for study years, it's not what you share, I'm aware of my study years. But we struggle. We study more to first exam.
You study more to first exam? Okay. Yeah, true. But there are times when I'm dead or anything, but it's not. My mother. Don't let me tell you, please, but then I'm here, but then I'm here. Yeah, this is why I don't give you, because I want you to search. I want you to not be like chickens where you just swallow and then you come in and examine for me and then it is. You need to read more. Irene, you say the exam.
So I feel like when you write an exam,
whether the child is learning or not. So that's another training that is happening. So if you ask me, I would say that the education, the early childhood education, it is now becoming, or they are changing it from what it is supposed to be, and overtaking the pace of the child, disregarding the level of understanding and exposing the child to something that is beyond it. So when you go to standard one, at least these days the government has said, but 5 years ago, you would find in standard one, you've got a 4 year old. That's in standard one. And even when they are in standard one, it's not that they can't do what the rest is doing, what the rest are doing. They are doing that. But because they have been given things beyond their age at a very early age. So this child hasn't been given a time to be a child. 4 years in standard one, five, when they are in standard six or seven, they are about 10 years. 11 years they are in form one. 12, 13, 14, 15 is done with secondary school. And they are going to college. So you can see that at every level, this one is supposed to handle something that is beyond their age. So sometimes it's good, yes, but sometimes you are not allowed, you're not given a chance to be what you are supposed to be. There is a curriculum model which is known as WADOF curriculum model, whereby here normally we divide the stages of development from what is the early stage of, what is the early childhood stage? What are the ages? From birth to? Hmm? 2 years? Middle childhood? Okay. So this model, what it does is, it demarcates from birth to 7 years. This one is early childhood. From 7 to 14, that's middle childhood. From 14 to 21, that's an adolescent. So you can see that a child has got an extended childhood from zero, I mean from birth to 7. Whether you are 6 years or you're 7, you're still a child. From 7 to 14, whether you are 13, you are still in your middle childhood, but you are a teenager. So at 21, you can still claim to say I'm an adolescent. Whatever I am.